I haven't put a second of thought into this. It's not on my radar screen. That's House Speaker Paul Ryan today talking about the Stormy Daniels story. And there's at least one reason why it shouldn't be on his radar, or frankly ours. Whatever happened, if it happened, was between two consenting adults. Marital infidelity is certainly nothing new in Washington or elsewhere. And if that were it, there'd be no reason to go any further. Keep it honest, though, it's not just about allegations of marital infidelity. It's about paying to hush it up in a deal that was struck just days before the election using a shell corporation, phony names, payments that triggered suspicion that banking laws were being violated, and many more questions about the money itself, not the least of which is where did it actually come from? Here's Press Secretary Sarah Sanders yesterday without many answers about what the president knew about the $130,000 payment to Stormy Daniels facilitated by Mr. Trump's personal attorney, Michael Cohen.
When did the president address specifically the cash payment that was made in October of 2016?
The president has denied the allegations against him. And again, this case has already been won in arbitration. Anything beyond that, I would refer you to outside counsel.
Did he know about that payment at the time, though?
I've addressed this as far as I can go.
Payment. Did he know about the payment at the time?
Not that I'm aware of. And again, anything beyond what I've already given you, I would refer you to the president's outside counsel. Steve.
Michael Cohen about that since this has become a news story this week. Yes. Has he talked to Michael Cohen about it? If I can just ask one more
time. I'm sorry?
Has he talked to Michael Cohen about that this week since this has become news?
I'm not sure.
Well, that's not good enough to many, including some Republicans. Congressman Mark Sanford, who had an affair while governor of South Carolina, had this to say about the nondisclosure agreement that Stormy Daniels signed. Quote, it's nefarious, it's awkward, it's unpleasant, it's unseemly, it's not something people feel that comfortable talking about, but frankly, it's something we ought to talk about because it is a big deal. Watchdog groups agree, including Common Cause, which has filed complaints with the Federal Elections Commission and the Justice Department, alleging Cohen's payment to Daniels amounts to an illegal campaign contribution or expenditure.
You know, if this FEC does not investigate, and that's all we're asking for, does not open an investigation into this matter, this FEC is hopeless.
Michael Cohen, you'll recall, said that he paid Stormy Daniels out of his own pocket, something CNN legal analyst Paul Callen doubts highly.
He didn't know that his own lawyer paid a porn star $130,000? Boy, that's some lawyer. Remember, Michael Cohen, the lawyer, says he paid it out of his own money. You ever meet a lawyer who reached into his pocket for $130,000 to help out a client? I don't think so.
And we should note, as a backdrop to all this, today, of course, is International Women's Day.